The Sutton's key police detective who informed me of my mother's death was named Aiello, and he spoke in that familiar, thick-throated drawl I had grown up to know as Appalachian English. He told me about Dennis shuffling half-naked along the shoulder of the highway, too, and how he had personally responded to the call because he was already in the area. Sure enough, there was Dennis, pink and shiny in the sun, doing the Frankenstein's monster shamble down the highway. Detective Aiello had gotten out of his car and approached Dennis, attempted to engage the peculiar fellow in conversation, but Dennis hadn't responded to the detective or even acknowledged that Aiello was standing there at all. Dennis had simply continued his laborious, barefooted trek along the gritty shoulder of the highway as if under a hypnotist's spell. Detective Aiello, whose law enforcement career spanned 11 years, although his transfer to the Sutton's Key Police Department had been fairly recent, had the good sense to realize there was something decidedly off about my brother, even without taking into considering the fact that he was trudging along the road half-naked in the middle of the day. So instead of attempting to slap a pair of silver bracelets on my brother and muscle him into a police car, which would have been a chore, Detective Aiello radioed dispatch for assistance, then proceeded to walk with Dennis for about a quarter of a mile. It was hot as hell, but Aiello figured he could use the exercise. Just as Aiello heard sirens coming over the hill, Dennis stopped walking. He blinked his small gray eyes, and for the first time since Aiello had joined him on his journey, winced from the sizzling glare of the midday sun. It was as though he had just been roused from a deep sleep. He turned to Aiello, some semblance of clarity filtering back into his small and somewhat childlike eyes. Some of the moisture on my brother's face, Aiello suddenly realized, was tears. Dennis said something, which Detective Aiello could not readily make sense of. He asked Dennis to repeat himself, and Dennis obliged.
"She is now dead," said Dennis.